Hey guys, it's Ken Vandy, and welcome to part 1 of my new PowerDirector 16 tutorial series. My goal is to make at least 15 or so videos in this series that will touch on various aspects of PowerDirector that'll be first and foremost for beginners, but it's also going to be for the more experienced of you who just want a refresher or just want to make sure that you know all the little editing tricks that will help you work faster. I'm hoping to keep these videos as short and concise as possible, so that you can learn as much as you can about PowerDirector in the least amount of time, except for maybe this video, because we've got a lot to go over, especially for those of you who have never used PowerDirector before. I'll be giving you a tour of PowerDirector so that you'll be a little bit more familiar with what you're looking at, especially if you're just using this for the first time. Now what we're looking at right now is the startup launch screen. For all of my tutorials, you're going to want to keep the aspect ratio at 16 by 9, and we're going to enter the timeline mode. And here we are in the default interface of PowerDirector. Now notice PowerDirector opens up by default in the Edit tab, and that is where we're going to be spending most of our time here, on the Edit tab. But notice that the Edit tab is actually only the second out of four other tabs. So let's take a quick look at all the other tabs and what their purpose is. This first tab is called the Capture tab. This is where PowerDirector has tools built in where you can immediately start recording from like a webcam, or an external camera, a microphone. You can even record your screen if you want. Now, I personally never actually used the Capture tab. I like using other programs like Audacity or OBS. But if you really want to use only PowerDirector itself for all your media production, it is possible. Now back to the Edit tab, which we've already seen. Now this is where we'll be spending almost all of our time in PowerDirector, at least when we're like editing the video and such. I'll be talking about this in a lot more detail in just a minute. Here, I'll drag something to the timeline just so I can go to the next tab. This is the Produce tab. In the Produce tab, this is where you render your final video that you have edited into a single file, or optionally you can also render it and directly upload it to a website. I'll have a special video about producing your videos linked in the description, or you can clip the card up here in the right-hand corner of the video. And there is a fourth tab called Create Disk, and this is where instead of rendering it into a file, you can burn your video project onto a CD, DVD, or Blu-ray. As you can see, you can make nice little DVD menus and stuff like that, but depending on who you are or what you really want to do with PowerDirector, you may never even use this tab. I've actually used it in the past quite a bit, at least a few years ago when I was doing stuff for school projects and stuff like that. Leave a comment below if you would actually want to see a tutorial on this, because I don't know how many people would actually want that. Now let's get back to the Edit tab. As I said, this is the main part of PowerDirector that we will almost always be in. Now there are three main sections of the screen that we can see here. The Library, the Media Preview, and the Timeline. This section with all the image and video files is your library. There are many rooms within the library that I will go over in just a second, but also now, on the bottom here is the most important section, and that is the timeline. The timeline is where we put all of our videos, images, or audio files. I will also be covering this extensively in part 3 of this tutorial series. Click the card in the upper right hand corner if you want to skip to that and get started right away. And on the right here we have our preview section. From here we can preview video files from the library or from the timeline itself. And here's something kind of important. You can change the preview quality of your video preview to match the capabilities of your computer. For example, if you have a really good, powerful computer, you can go ahead and preview your videos in full HD resolution. I usually keep mine on about HD resolution because my computer's just kind of good. I've got a Core i7. However, if you have an older or slower computer, you're probably going to limit your preview quality to high preview or high resolution instead of HD, because it might be a little choppy for you. If you have a really bad or old computer, I don't know, you can start getting down to the normal or low preview. Or if what you're editing is really complicated, you might have to do this temporarily just to see what you're doing. And you can also resize all the areas of your workspace. For example, I'll make the timeline bigger, or I can make the preview bigger, depending on what you want to do or what part of your project you're in. Also, if you have multiple monitors, you can actually detach the entire preview window and drag it over. So that's pretty nice. I'll put it right back for now. Now for the rest of the video, I'll be going over all the rooms here in the library section. This first room that we're already in is called the Media Room. This is where all your videos, pictures, songs, or other audio recordings will be stored. There are a few different ways you can display your media. For example, we can go, right now we're on large icons, you can go to small icons if you have a ton of stuff. You can even go to details mode if you need to see the names of everything and the duration. Right now I'm going to go back to large icons. Now to import your files or media into your media room, you can either import your files from here, this little button here, and I'll just import a song. Or you can just have Windows File Explorer open, and then simply highlight your videos and then drag and drop them in. And I think this is the simplest method. So that's the media room. Now let's move on to the second room, and this room is called the effects room. And in this room there are dozens, maybe even 100 effects here that you can apply to your video clips or even some of your images. Though I only find a few of these actually useful. We'll use a couple of these, such as the blur, in some of my future tutorials. But quickly moving on, let's take a look at these next two rooms that are called the PIP Objects Room and the Particle Room, and they're pretty similar. The PIP Objects Room means the picture-in-picture, and I used to find this more useful a few years ago when I was using it, but now I don't really use it anymore. What this is a bunch of still or slightly animated pictures that are kind of transparent. They can kind of put over your videos. For example, here you can see who I've put over my first video, a little message bubble. Now, I only have a few of these actually in my library. So there's a lot more better ones. I only have the Ultra version of PowerDirector. So if you buy the Ultimate or Ultimate Suite, you'll get probably like 100 of these. Or you can just download free templates from the director zone from right here. Anyway, let's move on to the Particle Room. This is pretty much the same thing, but with more animated kind of things. So for example, here's some leaves. I can put this in a video track too. And it would kind of just look like that. And now let's move on to the Title Room. And this one is actually important. This is where, of course, you can add titles or text to your timeline. So do that, add a title here, and we'd have a title. Then the transition room is where you can add specialized transitions to your video. There are all kinds of transitions that you can use, of course. See, it looks like it got over 100 of them here. I only use about usually just the fade or the white transitions, but you can go through here and just take a look at all the different options you have. The next room is called the audio mixing room. Now, I truthfully have just never used this. I mean, what it is, see, when you have audio here, you can individually at certain points adjust the volume of your audio, but you can do the same thing on the timeline itself, so I think it's just kind of redundant. Next room, this is the voiceover recording room. Now, this is where you can, while playing your, you can actually record a voiceover. So this is pretty useful for some of you out there who like probably doing YouTube videos and stuff like that. And the second to last room is called the Chapter Room, and this is really only useful if you're making a DVD or Blu-ray and you want to have different chapters, you know, where like you can skip to in your DVD menu. So this is only useful for that, otherwise you can just ignore it. And then this last room is called the Subtitle Room, and it's different from the title room because it's meant specifically for subtitles, and you can either make your own subtitles on the fly, or you can just import an SRT file if your subtitles are already in that format. So that's pretty useful. And with that, I think I've gone over the majority of all the places in PowerDirector that you'll be. Be sure to watch part 2 of this tutorial series, where I'll be going over how to set up your PowerDirector settings that work best for you. And part 3, where I'll go over the basics of editing in the timeline. And if you have any questions, be sure to ask them in the comments below. And if you were just watching this video to get a good look at PowerDirector and you haven't bought PowerDirector yet, I've got a link and a 12% off coupon code in the description, so be sure to look for that. Anyway, guys, hope you guys have a great day, and click here for the next tutorial.